Oh, can I also see them? Oh, thank you so much. Slide. My president, thank you so much for having this presentation about our national classification with focusing on interventions classifications. And my presentation will be about health and social care in Sweden and about the National Board of Health and Welfare, where I am working since 2077. I will also have a presentation about our health-related classification and some use cases. Focusing on functioning. Next slide, please. Thank you, Thomas. Sweden is a long country and we have 290 municipalities and 21 regions. The regions are responsible for healthcare in hospital and in open specialized care and primary care. The municipalities are responsible for social care and health care in specialized form of housing like nursing homes and also in ordinary home. In Sweden are licensed professionals such as nurses, occupational therapists and physiotherapists working in the municipalities. And also sometimes dietitians. But the physicians who are responsible for the patients in the municipality's health care are working in primary care. And the National Board of Health and Welfare are the authority for health and social care and are responsible for a wide range of activities and duties. The majority of our activities focus on staff, managers and decision makers. We give support in many different ways, such as we collect, compile, analyze, and pass information. And we have different health data registers at individual level. As in Sweden, we have specific person numbers for each person. We develop standards based on legalizations and the collected information. And all collected data is restricted by regulations. Next, please. The National Board of Health and Welfare are responsible for this health-related classification. We update the classifications every year and we have the distribution of them. We have the Swedish version of ICD-10 and are now working for transfer to ICD-11. We also have ICF in Swedish version, and we update also this every year according to the accepted ICF updates from WHO network. We have two classifications for interventions, one for health care called classification of health care interventions, KVO, and one for social care, classification of social care interventions and activities. KVO, the next slide, please. KVO consists of two parts. Classification of surgical procedures, KKO, and classification of medical procedures, KMO. Totally about 10,000 interventions, and the surgical part consists of about 6,000 interventions, and the medical part about 4,000 interventions. The first Swedish surgical classifications was developed in the beginning 1960. 1997 was KKO implemented, and this is a translation of the Nordic or Nomesco classification of surgical procedures, NCSP. And this is a part of KVO since 2007. The medical part was developed and published 2005, so it come later. This part include medical procedures, such as for anesthesia, mental health, and functioning interventions, including nursing. And the classification had different parts, such one part for diagnostic investigative interventions and one part for therapeutic interventions. Two chapters in the medical part of the classification, where the were developed during 2007 and 8. One chapter for investigative assessment interventions and one for therapeutic supportive interventions. And this part, these two chapters, are targeting ICF in the same way as Richard have talked about earlier. But the actions differ a little from ICHI. As we have more general actions, we have only some few, as example, assessment. And assessment include test, observation, and other things. We have training, support, and tasks performed by another. The next slide, please. The National Board of Health and Welfare have done some mapping from KVO to ICHI. We started with 50 orthopedic surgical interventions and 50 functioning interventions. The results show that 70% of the surgical interventions need map to one ICHI stem code, and the other needs two or three ICHI stem codes. And for the surgical interventions, you also need extension codes to get exactly map. For the functioning interventions, it was different because about 80% need more than one ICHI stem code. So the functioning interventions we have in KVO at the moment is more like a package of interventions. And for the functioning interventions, we do not need so many extension codes, only a few. So our experience are that we can see if we are going to transfer to ICHI, we are going to have more specific functioning interventions by using ICHI than we have today in our national classification. The next slide, please. Then we also have developed a national classification for social care, and that was commissioned by the government to cover the interventions in social care. And social care in Sweden focus on supporting daily activities for persons with disabilities, elderly persons, child and youth, persons with addictive problems, and economic support. And in social care, they don't use ICD at all, because they are more focusing on if the persons can or need support for daily living and daily activities. So when we started and we have the commission to develop KSC, we need a structure. And the structure and content is based on ICHI. And we have developed KSC in close collaborating with ICHI, as I have been involved in the ICHI development since 2012, and I was also responsible for the development of KSC. So KSC focusing on interventions, targeting activities and participations, environmental factors, and health-related behaviors. And it consists about 1,800 interventions. KSC was developed during some years and was finalized 2015. And we did it from bottom up. We involved about 217 professionals from 60 municipalities. We involved experts and other organizations. So they identify which target was actual and which actions, because we don't need the means in this classification. And the purposes for KSC is to establish a common language for naming and describing the interventions and activities in social care, but also for increasing legal security for the individual by having a clear description of the interventions. Because before, the different municipalities have their own naming and their own description, and sometimes they didn't have any description of the interventions. But also by using KSC, you can enable comparisons of interventions and between social care and over time. And you can use the coding systems for documentation system behind the digital documentation. And the classification consists of 15 chapters. The next slide, please. The National Board of Health and Welfare manage and distribute the classifications in different formats, because now we are working to now have the classifications in a book format. We need to support the digital use in the digital documentation in the electronic health record and so on. So we have different API, XML format, text and Excel format. And we also have a browser as you can use and search for the classifications. And this browser you can see cover ICD, ICF, KVO, the two different parts, and KC. Please, the next slide. Now I will show a use case, one we have had for a long time, the patient's register, which we collect data for inpatient by using ICD and KVO. We also collect data at individual base, because we have the person number in Sweden, for open specialized care. And here is diagnosis and interventions performed by the physicians collected. So it's different between the inpatient and open specialized care. The collection started 1964, and since 1987, we have data for all inpatients in the whole country. And here's also the functioning interventions reported. The plan is to improve the data to cover all professionals in open psychiatric care, including functioning interventions. And we hope we are going to do that maybe next year or the year after that. We also have a plan or proposals to collect data from primary care, including functioning interventions, and also data by using ICF and, of course, ICD. Next slide, please. Then I will show you a use case about the National Register for the municipalities and the healthcare. National Board of Health and Welfare approved a regulation 2018 about collecting perform interventions for the patients who receive municipalities healthcare. They have to report each intervention performed per day and the professional who performed interventions. And that is from licensed professionals such as nurses, occupational therapists, or psychotherapists. The interventions should be classified by using the most specific intervention code, IKVO. And I can tell you, in the part for the medical interventions, we have some overlaps, because sometimes we can have a really, really general package of interventions, and sometimes, and also we also have more specific interventions. And the coverage of use of KVO has increased from about 40% 2015 to over 80% 2019. And now they should report KVO, and we have the next, please. The work started already 2080, so it's take long time before you can start to collect data. The National Board of Health and Welfare, we was commissioned by government to focus on needs for elderly persons and persons with disability within both social care and healthcare in the municipalities. And then we started to describe how to assess the patient's needs, because that was not clear. And we used this needs-oriented process, because if you want to describe the patient's needs, you can't only use the diagnosis, because you need to describe and assess the current functioning. You need to decide the goal together with the patients, and after that assess the needs of interventions. But one also important thing is to follow up the results after the treatment, and then you use the ICF to assess the current functioning again and if you have achieved the goal. And here you can see that you also need to use KVO to describe the planned and performed interventions, both in the investigation, assessment, and for the treatment. Next slide, please. In Sweden, we also have the national strategy for e-health in Sweden, and I think that is also in a lot of other countries. And that means that we have to use more structured documentation with coded information to facilitate reusing the information for different purposes, such as sharing information within and between health professionals and caregivers, for statistics at different levels, for research, for quality improvement. The National Board of Health and Welfare has developed a national information structure consisting of process models, concepts models, and information models, where the classifications are part of the national multi-professional terminologies, which also consist of SNOMCT. National Board of Health and Welfare has regulations and general recommendations for documentation in the electronic health record. And they said we have to use unambiguous terms in the records for the patient, the person. And these regulations also recommended to use the ICD, ICVO, and ICF. And here you can see the process, and you can see the blue cells is how you can use the classification of interventions. The red is how you can use ICF, and the brown about ICD. The next slide, please. The work to describe the process for patients in municipalities started with different studies to identify the used information in the health records, to describe a general process, to identify structured information and so on. And then we started already 2018. We developed subsets of ICF and from COVO for use in the municipalities' healthcare, to make it easier for the professionals to choose correct codes. The first version of the subsets was published 2013. Yes. And the subsets updates every year. And as you can see, ICF consists of 280 ICF categories and COVO about 358 interventions. But the health professionals can also choose if they need other interventions and ICF categories from the whole classification if they want. But as we have developed the subsets, it's also increased the quality of data. As I said earlier, we have some overlap, as example, in COVO. We also have developed e-learning tool to make it easier for the professionals in the municipalities and the decision maker to understand why it is important to use structured documentation and also use ICF and COVO for the possibilities for them to reuse the classifications for local follow-up and quality improvement. The next slide, please. Before we started collecting the information 2019. We have about 21 regional conferences. We travel around in Sweden, have information, education about ICF and COVO and our register and how to report the data. Only we report the data for COVO. But during the whole process, we have our thoughts are that it's important to not only have COVO about interventions, because we also need ICF, as I said earlier, to describe the patient's functioning in goal setting, but also for follow up the result, because you can't follow up the result by only using ICD. And as you can see, they are saying, now we are going to have data. We can show them for the decision maker and the politicians. Before we have, we only can say that we have thoughts, we experience, and so on. So they are really happy when they experience that they can have data also for the local follow-up and quality improvement and following trends during the years. Next slide, please. Here is an example where I show the data from one municipalities and how they have reported the interventions, performed interventions for investigation. And here you can see the part of the classification. We have one part with targeting body functions, one part targeting activities and participation, and the last green one, environmental factors. And as you can see, the most frequently performed diagnostic interventions were targeting body functions, and after that, activities and participations. But you can also see that the most used diagnostic interventions targeting mobility and inactivity and participation, and functions of the skin and related structures, mental functions and sensory functions and pain. But you can also see there are no performed interventions for some areas, such as voice and speech functions, interpersonal interactions, relationships, major life areas and community, social and civic life. And only to show this diagram raises a lot of questions which can be used for local quality improvement. Next slide, please. Here is only one use case when we use the classification for health indicators to follow the process, because we want to follow up how many patients have received a follow-up about the prescription of wheelchairs or other assistive devices. And here you can see it's about 40% who has received a follow-up within 6 months. So that is also another use case. The next one. In social care, the National Board of Health and Welfare has supported the implementation of ICF during a long time, since 2012. First focusing on elderly persons, and after some year also persons with disabilities. We started to describe the process and the information for documentation with the practice within the municipalities and companies which develop electronic records to solve how to structure the documentation with use of ICF and use the qualifiers. We developed the classification for social care interventions to complement ICF in the process. And we have a national information specification to describe how to use the classification in digital structured documentation. We also developed a subset for ICF, and we have developed subsets also for CSC. We also educate local process leaders to support the implementation and use of the model and the classification. Next slide, please. Here you can see a print screen from social care and how they use ICF and CSC in the digital structured documentation. To the left, you can see ICF, and here is assessment of washing oneself, and they use the qualifiers, and in the goal setting, they hope and set the goal that the patient should have minor problems. And they also use narrative text to explain more to the structured documentation. The next slide, here you can see how you complement with CSC, because here you can see how you use the CSC, and in the digital structured documentation, they have, use and show all interventions which targeting washing oneself, you can see in the right. So here you have training in washing oneself, advising, performing the task, practical support, and emotional support. And then this makes it easier for the professionals to do the documentation directly in the electronic health record. And here you can see the codes, and the codes is behind the structured documentation, because the professionals and the patients do not need to see the codes. Thank you. The next slide. The use of ICF has increased during the years, and here you can see the coverage of ICF in the municipalities, and that has increased especially for elderly persons and persons with disability. You can see that in the left diagram. And that, I think that is also depending on that we have supported this area more than the other one. And in the right diagram, you can see CF has also increased in the municipalities' healthcare. So it's about 84% of the municipalities who use ICF instructed digital documentation this year. Next slide. I will finalize my presentation by showing you how the free reference classification from WHO can be used and how these complement each other in the same way as I have present for the Swedish version of the classifications. You can see that each can be used to describe, report, analyze, plan, and perform the interventions. ICF to describe, assess, and analyze functioning in goal setting, needs assessment, and follow-up results. And ICD to describe and classify health conditions. Next slide, please. So my conclusion are that interventions classification are very useful to describe, plan, and perform the interventions in the care process. And as you can understand, I am working a lot with the functioning interventions and more and the medical intervention, not so much with the surgical interventions. The classifications provide a common language, unambiguous terms, and a framework, and are useful in different areas of care. There are several use cases for the interventions classifications, such as for the structured documentation directly in the electronic health record to make it possible to reuse the information, for collecting comparison of data, for follow-up and work with quality improvement in both health and social care at local, national, and regional level. And I think the most important is that the professionals and decision makers get information to understand the benefits of using the classifications for follow-up, manage the care, and for quality improvement at local level, because they need to understand how they can use it at local level. Because if they can understand that, they facilitate the implementation of the classification, but also for the understanding of using them and why we are using them, not only for reporting to our national register. So great thanks to all for your attention, and hope this have given you some inspiration to continue your work with the classifications. And please do not hesitate to contact me for more information. Thank you so much.
Okay, and we thank you, Ann-Helen, for your presentation. Please stay with us for a while, because I think we do have questions. Vážení přátelé, teď je pro vás ta příležitost, kdy i vy můžete položit naší přednášející nějaký dotaz. Jediné, co stačí, napsat do Zoomu, položit otázku a my už vám ji přineseme. Respektive pan doktor Miroslav Zvolský nám ji přinese a my ji předneseme naší přednášející. Je tu s námi opět taky paní docentka Petráková. Tak já vám možná rovnou předám slovo, jestli vy máte nějaký dotaz, než nám přijde nějaký dotaz z chatu.
Děkuji za slovo. Já bych také poděkovala Ann-Helen za její velmi zajímavou přednášku a dodala bych, že ona v současné době od roku 2020 je ve vedení jedné z komisí, která se zabývá vlastně mezinárodními klasifikacemi na půdě Světové zdravotnické organizace. Takže je odborník na svém místě. Thank you, Ann-Helen, very much. I was just introducing that you are in co-chairing one of the committees related with international health classifications for FIC for WHO. So you are the expert who was sharing your experiences with our audience. And we have some questions for you. Máme několik otázek a v podstatě jedna z otázek, která by mě zajímala, je otázka jazyková. What about the languages in Nordic countries for classification? Swedish, Danish language? Yes. I know that it might be similar. What about Norway and Finland? Do you have classification in mother tongue for each of the Nordic countries?
Yes. We have that. We have Swedish translation, they have Danish translation, and Norway, France, and also in Finland, Finnish. And the Finnish, they also use Swedish in some places, so they use our translation.
Thank you very much. Děkuji.
Děkujeme a zdá se, že máme dokonce možná i dotaz z chatu. Teď nám tam v přímém přenosu přichází, tak já nevím, jestli pan doktor Zvolský už je připraven.
Já budu odezírat pravým okem. Já bych na dotaz, který se tady teďka rodí v tom chatu, tak bych udělal takového předskokana. Chtěl bych se zeptat, kdo je tím, kdo v severských státech kóduje, vlastně kdo používá systémy pro kódování procedur nebo intervencí, která je ta odbornost, jestli jsou to lékaři, spíše jestli jsou to profesionální kodéři, a jestli je to nějaká jiné povolání nebo nějaká jiná funkce, která nejvíce pracuje s tím systémem a jaká je případně dělba rolí nad tím. And Helen, probably I should repeat this in English to...
Yes, thank you, because I didn't understand. Yeah, sorry.
Not yet Czech language.
My question was, what is the specialty that is responsible, in charge for coding with those classifications of interventions? Is it doctors, professional coders, or other professional, and what is what are bindings between the workflow of these professionals?
Yes, in hospital you have coders, and for the open specialist care, but I know for the rehabilitation professionals working in the hospital, sometimes in use both ICF and our national classification of interventions. So they did the coding directly by their own professionals. And in the municipalities' healthcare, we didn't have any coders. So the professionals are doing this directly in the electronic health record. Instead of writing in free text, they choose the ICF codes and the qualifiers and wrote narrative text more to explain it, and they choose the intervention.
There are advantages and disadvantages of this, pros and cons. The question from the chat is, do you have certified coders using all these classification at the local level? If yes, how long do you train them? So it was a little bit a part of the previous question.
Yes.
But what is the education, what is the training for?
We didn't have as training as we want to have, but we have a subset and we have talked and we, express that they, it's what to say, if they use the subsets, it's easier to use the same interventions. And we also answered question if they have some about how to use them. We have also now decided to develop advising how to use the some of the interventions. As example, you have developed a rehabilitation plan, and when you have follow up the rehabilitation plan, that is another code. And when you revise the rehabilitation plan, you need to do double coding, as example. And we also have. You have prescription of assistive devices. We have one intervention about training. And then we also have a need to have advice that then if they have prescription and training at the same time, they need to double code. And so we didn't have specific education for these professionals. We have the e-learning tool that we have some explanation how to use the classification, but ICF has been used in the municipalities since I think 2006-07, so it's not a new classification. they are familiar with the classification.
And they are happy with it, with that, because it's somehow a new work for them to use this classification. If they are okay with that, it's perfect. I think that in the Czech Republic, it will be a problem to force clinicians to use some new tool, some extra work, administrative work, let's say, for them to use it. But the data are very important. So if the clinicians in Sweden are happy with this way, it's perfect.
Yes, yes, but it's not extra work because they do the documentation directly. Instead of writing everything in free text, they make some choice to make it structured so you can collect data. And then they also write some narrative, but they didn't need to write some narrative text so much. But I can say for the social care, we have specific education of the local process leaders, how go back to the municipalities and educate more in social care. And that is also about thinking more, focusing on the patient's needs, not so much because before you focusing on the interventions. But we want to change the approach to look what need the patients or persons.
Helen, model. We need to bring you to the Czech Republic to advocate ICF and ICHI.
Yes.
In the next future, I think.
Ano,
thank you so much.
Obávám se, tu dnes budu za toho zlého muže konference, protože náš čas se naplnil. Takže ještě jednou, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much for the invitation. I hope it have give you some inspiration to continue the work.
Okay, goodbye to Stockholm. Bye.
Goodbye.
Greetings.
Thank you so much.
Have a nice day.
Děkujeme.
The same to you all.